What if you don't yet know the invoice you want to apply the credit to? For example, on February 24, Holden issued credit memo number 3 to Candy for 2 editing hours. Candy did not yet decide what invoice she wants it applied to. Now, here's Candy's open invoice report before we record the credit. 2 editing hours equals $280. So if we record a credit and we do not apply it to one of the open invoices, it means that the credit will be just sitting there on the open invoice report waiting to be applied. Of course, it will lower the balance of Candy, but it will be listed separately from the invoices, and it will not affect the invoices until it's applied. So Candy's open invoice report will look something like this after we record a credit that we did not apply. Let's take a look. Here's Candy's open invoice report, and from the main menu, we click Customers, Create Credit Memo / Refund. Now, the customer is Candy. The date that we are recording the credit is February 24. The computer remembers this is credit memo number 3. The item we're giving credit for is editing, and the quantity is 2. When we push tab, we see that this is a credit memo for $280. At the moment we click Save and Close, we click the Keep Number pop-up, and then the Available Credit window will come to us. Do we want to apply it to an invoice, give a refund, or retain as an available credit? In this example, we click Retain as an available credit. When we click OK and we look at the open invoice for Candy, we can see this credit memo is a minus to Candy's balance. It lowers the amount that she owes us, and you can see it is separate from the invoices, and none of the individual invoices have been affected yet. Someday in the future, Candy decided to apply the credit that we just made specifically to invoice number 15. The reason I say someday in the future is because only applying a credit is not a transaction. QuickBooks does not record the date that you apply or unapply a credit. So here's Candy's open invoice. Now, all you have to do is double click on the invoice that you're applying the credit to, use the command in the ribbon, and simply choose the credit that you wish to apply. In this case, we're applying the credit to invoice number 15. After we do that, the credit will disappear from the open invoice report, and invoice number 15 will decrease and become 1,720. Here we are at the actual open invoice report for Candy. We double-click invoice number 15, and in the ribbon, there's a command, Apply Credits. The command is in the tab of Main. Notice the ribbon has 1, 2, 3, 4 tabs, but you have to click on the Main tab to get the ribbon that has this command, Apply Credits. When we click on it, the Apply Credits window opens up. If there were several credits, you would see several credits listed here, and you would have to click on the one that you're choosing to apply. Because there's only one credit on this list, QuickBooks automatically clicked the check mark here and selected credit number 3, because that's the only credit that Candy has available. We click Done, and notice the balance due for this invoice has already decreased to $1,720. When we click Save and Close, we notice that the open invoice report shows invoice number 15 is down to $1,720, and the lingering credit that was at the very bottom has disappeared. You might need to unapply a credit if you applied that credit to the wrong invoice. What would you do if you applied the credit to the wrong invoice? Well, step 1, open the invoice that already has the credit. Step 2, click the Apply Credit command that we just learned about. Step 3. Remove the check mark next to the credit you are changing. Step 4. Open the correct invoice. And step number 5. Apply the credit from the command in the ribbon. Let's reapply the credit we just applied to number 15 to number 10. If we take the credit that we applied to number 15 and we reapply it to number 10, that means number 15 will bounce back to the original balance of $2,000, and invoice number 10 will decrease by the $280 and become $720. So when we're finished reapplying this credit, this is what Candy's open invoice report will look like. Once again, here are Candy's numbers before we reapply this credit. All you have to do is double-click on number 15, because that's the invoice that has the credit. In the main tab, go to the right of the ribbon and click our command, Apply Credits. Notice the credit that we made, number 3, has now been moved to the bottom section because it says this is credits that were previously applied. All you have to do to unapply the credit is remove the check mark by clicking on it. When you click Done, notice the balance of invoice number 15 has gone up to $2,000. Click Save and Close. Now, the credit has returned to the open invoice report because now it's unapplied. Very simple. All you have to do is double-click number 10, click the Apply Credits command, and then all you have to do is agree that the check mark should be on invoice number 3, because this is the only, credit number 3, because this is the only credit that Candy has. If there were several, you would have to choose the right one by clicking on it. When we click Done, notice the balance of invoice number 10 goes down to $720. And when we click Save and Close, the numbers in Candy's open invoice are exactly as what we expected.